Hey guys, you guys requested for me to do an everyday makeup look. So I put my hair up so that you guys can see how I put on makeup. Okay, so my first thing I do is I get my e.l.f. mineral and primer and I put that all over my face. I put it all over because it's like a first layer to everything that I put on my face. But this would be like for any type of occasion. This is really good. It feels like a first layer, like your face is fresh. Feels really, really good. Okay, so the next thing I do is I get my Flawless Brow Trio. And I fill in my eyebrows. Let's see if I can even open this. Okay, so it comes with this little brush. So I use it to align the bottom of my eyebrows. So I will show you this. I don't overfill them because I don't like the way super dark eyebrows look. So I just try to fill them in enough. And then I sort of clean them up a little bit. Okay, so that's how it looks. I guess it looks really dark right now because of the brightness. But right now, once I finish, it'll look much lighter, trust me. The other eyebrow. I really don't like a big square in the front, so I kind of clean them up. Okay, so I just filled in my eyebrows, and now I'm going to. What do I do next? I usually don't under highlight my eyebrows until I'm finished. So my next thing is I'm going to put on a little bit of foundation just to cover up my face. It just depending on the day if I want to, what's it called? If I want to conceal a lot, and I'm not really gonna conceal a lot today, but I'll just apply my foundation. And I will show you how I apply my foundation. I get my little sponge. I use This is the one. I use the water. And then I squish a little bit. And then I grab a little bit. And I go under my eyes. Sorry, guys. I can't really see because the lighting is too bright. That's why my eyebrows look really, really dark. But. Can't even open this. Okay, there you go. So I go under my eye, under my eyebrow, and then around my eyebrow, and up here to my forehead, and then grab a little bit more, and then come down here, just to cover any like blemishes and stuff like that. And then I just continue the process on the other side. Sometimes I blend it in with my fingers instead of using the beauty blender, but today I just feel like using the beauty blender. And this is why I put my hair up, because when I get to this line right here, I don't want to have hair in front of my face and catch foundation in my hair. But either way, most of the time I have my hair up. Okay, so now I just take the excess foundation and I blend to my neck, because I feel like you can tell when somebody's wearing makeup if you don't blend your neck. So I'm wanting to like blend my neck. Okay, so this is basically, I look really, really white right now because of the light. And because of the lighting in here, because there's no... Oops. Here you go. One second. Okay. So it's a lot brighter in here. And I don't look as dark. I mean, as white. Why do I look really white right now? So maybe I should close. A little bit open so that you can kind of tell. So right here it kind of looks... Oh, I'm sorry, I forgot to tell you which foundation I use. I use the Fit Me 210 Maybelline foundation. It has SPF 18. I really love this one. But if you guys know of a better foundation that's like not cheap, but like drugstore brand or something, and you guys think I should try it, let me know and I will go pick something up like that. Okay, so the next thing that I do for an everyday makeup look is I grab my Pro Concealer. My Pro Concealer from LA Girl to highlight my face. And sometimes I don't highlight my face, I just do like a natural look. But I guess today I feel like doing highlight. So I will show you how I highlight. If I can get this thing open. Okay, so first, squeeze this thing because this little tube. Okay, there. Because I have to squeeze the little tube. So first, I grab under my eyes. I put some right here. And I kind of make a thing like this. And then like a triangle too. But I like it to be highlighted to the other side. Okay, I'll do a triangle on that side. And then I do a triangle on this side. Okay, so basically like this, and then I do it right here, and then I do it on the bridge of my nose, a little dot right here on my upper lip, and then this come out, and then I do lines like this on the bottom, just so when I'm contouring, okay, so I look kind of weird, but just when I'm contouring, like, I have a specific spot where I'm able to, like, blend in really well. So okay. So now that I look like this, with all this stuff on my face, I might have to open the new one, but Okay, so just to fix this, to do this, this, just to make sure I got everything right here, and then I'm going to get my beauty blender, and I am going to blend. So. Right now, I look super pale and stuff because I'm highlighting, but, since this highlighter is kind of really, like, well, it's not highlighter, it's concealer, but I like to use it as highlighter because I love the way it highlights, and I don't like that shimmery stuff. I don't like shimmery on my face, so, so I just do like a really, really light yellow so that it'll look like a highlighter. So that's why I use this one. Okay, so now that I finished blending everything in, I am going to what do I usually do afterwards? Oh, sorry guys, I almost forgot. I'm gonna contour with the BH Studio Matte Finish Pressed Powder. I use this powder because, as you can tell, it's too dark for my skin tone. So I just use it as a contour. So this is the brush I'm gonna use. It doesn't have a name on it or anything. I will tell you what it is. But I'm gonna just use this. Grab a little bit of powder and contour. Oh, okay. And then when I feel like, sometimes when I go down too much on my, contour, I just grab my beauty blender and I, press it over where I think I, put excess, powder. Okay, so now you see that I contoured right here on the sides, and so now my next step is to powder my whole face. Unfortunately, my powder is almost done, the one that I do use, so I'm going to use a little bit of the ones that I have two of them, so I'm going to, the one I usually use, is a Dream Matte Powder. In the color Medium Sand. And the other one I use is the LA Girl powder in the color tan. So I'm gonna get the LA Girl and I'm going to put it right here on top as if I was contouring, kind of. Like that. Just a little bit so I don't look too dark, because with this powder I kind of look kind of dark sometimes depending on how I use it. And I'll use the other one that's in sand to just go over my whole face. So since it's almost done, not a lot of powder is collecting on my brush. So I'm just gonna grab a little bit more of the other girl to blend in like the rest of my face. I need to go buy a new powder, guys. Okay, so that's basically like my powder, and I do powder again, and when I contoured I forgot to contour my I always contour, to be honest, I always contour down here so that my face has more of a shape, because since I'm kind of overweight, like, you can't really tell the face. Like how my neck or my jawline is when I do my makeup. So I basically do that, and then I grab this one and I just kind of blend it. It's just so like I have a shape, but since I'm losing weight, you can kind of see my shape already. So my next step is. I usually don't wear like anything under, sometimes I do wear under my eyes, but sometimes I don't. So today I guess I'm gonna put a little bit of bottom eyeliner. So I'm gonna use the Italia Deluxe black eyeliner pencil just to put a little bit of color to my eyes. So I use this under my eye. So basically it's just a little bit under my eye. Love it when you talk, yeah, talk to me, yeah. And when I put on like this type of eyeliner, I kind of go into the corner of my eye. Hopefully you guys can hear me a lot better than yesterday, because I heard that you couldn't really hear me because of my music, so I decided to use music off my phone instead of the computer, because I guess if I use computer off the computer, use music off the computer, it overpowers my voice. So now I'm just gonna do the same thing to this side. Thank you. I'm going. Hey guys, sorry, it's because the doorbell, not the doorbell, somebody knocked on the door and it was because I got my Amazon packages. So okay, let's finish. So I finished with my eyeliner under my eyes, and now I'm gonna apply some mascara. It's the Rocket. It's Rocket by Maybelline, Volume Express. Sorry guys. So I'm just gonna apply a little bit of mascara. I don't curl my eyelashes, so that's why I didn't curl them, but I could just apply a little bit of mascara right now. And it's up to you how much you put. I usually put, like, I do one eye and then I let it dry a little bit and then apply a little bit more. So it's up to you. So basically it looks like that right now. And I do the other eye just so it could dry a little bit. And then I guess these eyelashes are weird, so I have to like keep going back to them and comb them out and stuff like that. So it looks like that. So I'm just gonna go over it. Hopefully I grabbed the right one. Yeah. And just go over them again. Sometimes I do my bottom lashes depending on how I feel. Today I'm not gonna do them because I kinda don't feel like having bottom eyelashes. So basically my eye will look like that with mascara. Sorry guys, I should turn that off. So basically that's how my eyelashes will look. And my next step is to get a little color to my face, since I just highlighted and I didn't and contoured. I think I could do a little bit of blush or a little bit of like a shimmer to my face. So I'm just gonna go like that. So I'm using I usually use blush or something, but for today I just wanna use like something shimmery. So I'm using this pink one. I don't know if you can see it. It won't focus. But this one. And it's like a really pink, a light pink, so that it'll give me like a little shimmer, like to the highlight. Just to give me a little bit of, just to give me a little bit of color, or a little bit of shimmer. I usually don't, but today I feel like a little bit of shimmer. So. And I have a little bit of excess black, so I just go like that. Or I get my beauty blender and my press, and I kind of take it off with the top, and then I'll clean it. Okay, so lastly, my lips. Usually I will use, for like an everyday look, I'll use, to make myself look bold, like if I'm wearing like a lot, even though I'm not wearing that much, I'll do, a lip liner, depending on how I feel, what lip liner I'll do. And so, right now, I'm going to grab, before I do that, I'm going to grab some powder to my lips. So it has a fresh look. Okay, I'm gonna grab, let's see, which pencil should I use? I'll do like a, an ombre look. So, I need 3 pencils for that. So let's just grab all my pencils right here, and we'll do like the mauve nudish. And I'm gonna show you guys a trick with the concealer. How I do my lips when I do them, when I do ombre. So first, I'm gonna grab this pencil, the nude pencil by Italia, and I guess it needs to be sharpened. So let's sharpen it quick. Okay, so I sharpened it, and first I'm just gonna outline my lips. And so you're gonna kind of darken your lips as much as you want. Shout out to Nikki, I love her. So I'm gonna kind of darken it. And I'll do the corners too. And I'll do the same for the top. I'll just do the corners of my lips. Okay, so now that I outlined my lips and kind of a little bit filled them in with the nude or with the mauve, I'm gonna get my Milani pencil, and it's in the color nude also, but this nude is like a pinkish nude, so it'll blend really well. So we're gonna kind of fill in the rest. To give it that pink look. And kind of get the other pencil real fast and re-outline the top. Okay, so now that I've done that, we're gonna grab our concealer. I'm gonna show you the trick. So I grab a little bit just to like make a really nice ombre look. I get it and I put it like that. To lighten it a little bit. Thank you. So that's basically what it looks like when I blend with the concealer. It looks really, really nice. I don't think you could really see the color, but it looks super nice. And after you kind of do the concealer, you just kind of go over it a little bit to darken everything else. I look out like this. I look out like this. So now my lips have that like little ombre feel, and they're really, it looks really, really nice. So lastly, after I do my lips and I kind of have almost my face done, all I'm going to do is grab, well, I need to clean it first real fast. I need to grab a wipe, clean my concealer a little bit from the lip, and I'm going to grab it. I'm gonna squeeze a little bit out, and I'm gonna put it under my eyebrows just to give it that highlight under my eyebrows. Okay, so now I'm just gonna blend that real quick. You can either grab your beauty blender or your finger, but I prefer my beauty blender because I can kind of blend in really well. I could blend. So I will put I will add pictures to this video so you guys can see my finished look, because you can't really tell right now. But this is like an everyday makeup look for me. When I do my makeup, I know it seems like a lot, but it's not really that much. You know, I just, this is what I basically do to my face. Oh, actually, I'm lying. I forgot to set my face. So this is what I do. I set my face, so I just spray a couple times and like let it dry, and I let it set, and that's my everyday makeup look. And right now I look kind of shiny because of the set, but right now once it's dry, it'll set completely. And I will add some pictures to this video so you guys can see the finished result, because you can't really tell right now because of the brightness. But that's my finished makeup look. Thank you guys for watching. Like, comment, subscribe, share my videos. Thank you so much for actually watching my videos and taking the time to watch them, because sometimes I know they're really long, but I appreciate it so much. Thank you. Love you guys so much. This is my finished look, guys. See, that's how it came out.